Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, my friends. This is my channel, Drilling and Workover. This is Abdelaziz Gabr. I am instructor in IWCF well control and IEDC well sharp. Also, I am instructor in mud engineering basic and advanced mud school. We have talked about the diverter. Today, we will get some questions about the diverter, and I hope to cover all the points that we have talked yesterday in these questions. So please pay attention to this important lecture. It's very important for you. The questions, let's check about the questions. Homie. Okay. Number one. When drilling shallow formations with no BOB installed, how often should you function test the diverter as per ABI standards? Okay, function test for the diverter. We have talked about it. We say it is daily. It is daily. So number A is the right answer. Number two, what happens when the diverter is closed? When the diverter is closed or when the diverter is activated, as I told you, you have to close the vent line, then close the diverter, then close. You have to close to open the vent lines, then close the diverter, and then close the flow line. So the best answer is number D. Number D, the vent line valve opens, and then the diverter backer closes. Number three, what is the weakest point in the diverter? And this is a question, number B, is the flow line connector seal is the weakest point. Number four, how can back pressure be reduced inside the diverter? I told you about it. The back pressure can be reduced by straight and short vent line and large diameter in vent line. So what is the best answer in number four is number C. Use short, straight vent line with large ID or internal diameter. Number five, which statements are correct about diverter vent lines? You choose two answers and two correct answers. Okay, so number five is, the two answers are number A, which is diverter vent lines must be as straight as possible. This is very important, so number A is the right answer. And number D, the diverter vent lines must have a large internal diameter to reduce back pressure. So number A and number D are the right answer for number five. Number six, what is the good practice for diverter vent line system? What is the good practice for diverter line system? So the best answer is number B. Diverter vent lines should have options to allow discharge downwind the rig. Downwind the rig. This is a very important question. Number seven, if the diverter has two vent lines and the wind is from east to west, take care. I told you from east to west. So the closed one is east. The closed one is east. Okay. In the case of shallow gas, what is the driller should do? What the driller should do? Number A is the best answer. As I told you, you have to close the east, as I told you, and open the west. So number A is the best answer. Open both vent lines, okay? Then activate the diverter, then close the east one, the east one. Number eight. You are drilling top hole with a diverter installed. The flow line is above the diverter, and the overboard vent lines are below the diverter. Take care of this. The overboard vent lines are below the diverter. Okay, the wind is coming from the east, which means the east must be closed after activating. Take care of these points. What pre-shift instructions would you give to the driller about the diverter procedures for this day? Number eight will be number D. D is the best answer. Open both overboard vent lines, then close the diverter, and then close the overboard line to the east. Close the east. Okay. Number nine. What design feature do diverter system have to minimize back pressure? To minimize back pressure, as I told you, for back pressure, straight vent lines with large diameter. So what is the best answer here? For number nine is number D. Number nine is number B. Large internal diameter, straight and short vent lines. So number B is the right answer. Number 10. The illustration shows diverter system during a drilling operation. Okay. With wind blowing from starboard. From starboard here to the port here. So to the port. So valve number B must be open, but valve number C must be closed at the final. What is the correct operational sequence for the diverter? As I told you, the sequence. What is the sequence to open the vent lines? So open the port. So open the port side vent, which means open valve number B. Then close the diverter. Close the diverter, which means close number A. And then close the flow line or the shaker, which is here number E. So open number A, B, close number A, close number E. So the right answer is number D. Open number B, close number E. Open number B, okay, close number E, and close the number E. This is very important. Number D is the right answer. Number 11. What are the components of 29.5-inch diverter system? You have to choose two answers, as I told you before. So what are here? What is the meaning of this? Number A is the right answer. A low pressure annular preventer with large internal diameter. This is the right answer, number A. And number E, also the right answer, which means a vent line of sufficient diameter to permit a safe venting and proper disposal of flow from the well. So number A and number E are the right answers. Number 12. Which of the following factors limit the success of diverter operation when shallow gas blowout occurs? You have to choose three answers. Three answers are, what are the limits of success? What are the failure of success for the diverter? Number A, rig air pressure equals zero. So this is number A question. Okay. Right answer is number A. Number B, the formation strength at the conductor casing show. Okay, it can also limit about this. Number B. And number C, diverter lockdown dogs unlocked, which means that it has a problem in closing the dogs over the bucker. So the right answers are number A, number B, and number C. Number 13, while drilling top hole with an insert type diverter, take care of this. What must you do when running or boiling the bottom hole assembly? So the right answer is number D. To remove the insert backer. Remove the insert backer is the right answer. Number D. Number 14, and this is the last question. What is the main advantages of insert type diverter compared to conventional large annular type of the diverter? So number 14, what is the right answer? It is number C. It has lower closing volume and it is faster to flowing. So this is very important question number C. Thank you very much. Today we have finished the questions of the diverter. If this video helped you, share, like, subscribe. Inshallah, we will talk tomorrow about the BOB and about the RAM type and extra. We will finish them. maybe the total course, it will be finished literally very soon. Thank you very much. See you, inshallah, tomorrow. A very important topic. It will be about the annular type BOB. Thank you very much. See you later, inshallah.